ACI Badem dispune și de un centru de cercetare foarte avansat, unde sunt dezvoltate terapii imunitare personalizate. Se ia sânge de la pacient, din care se recoltează celulele Natural Killer. Apoi acestea sunt modificate în culturi ca să poată acționa asupra celulelor canceroase pe care anterior nu le puteau distruge. Ulterior sunt testate pe animale și, dacă totul funcționează bine, se pot administra pacientului în aproximativ 2 până la 4 săptămâni. Aceste tratamente experimentale necesită aprobări speciale, dar reprezintă o șansă în plus pentru pacienții cu anumite tipuri de cancer, precum limfoame, leucemii, mielom multiplu sau melanoame, la care alte terapii au eșuat.
So these are generally the equipment that we use to, you know, purify different molecules to test them on different types of cancer cells or immune cells, so we can produce different proteins, purify them. We can analyze cells with high capacity and sort the different types of cells, like separate a cancer cell from an immune cell. This kind of machines are used to do that. And we can do high dimensional analysis using these machines, which are called flow cytometers, that enables us to measure multiple parameters on one single cell, like 20, 30 different molecules on a single cell and tens of thousands of cells per second. There we take the cells from the patient, we take blood from the patient.
Okay.
And then we take out from the blood the type of immune cell that we are interested in, which is generally either called a T cell or an NK cell, a natural killer cell. And then we modify the cell culture, and then we test them whether they are killing our tumor cells, which they couldn't before. If everything goes okay, then we of course take this to animal testing. And then after that, if the results are good, we can start clinical testing.
So 3 weeks is how long it takes us to grow the cells, and then there is a period of a couple of days where we do a quality control instance. So we freeze down the cells and then do all the quality controls, make sure that these are clean, there's no contamination.
It passes all the checkpoints, then we can give it to the patient. So 3-4 weeks.
Three-four weeks. Is you have a personalized treatment.
For yes.
You know what is the success rate?
Well, it depends a lot on the type of cancer and on the type of actual treatment you're using. But the very popular version of this is called the CAR T cells. You may have heard about it. With CAR T cells, you get about 70-80% response rates in patients that have gone through all the treatments and are not responding to anything anymore. So these are end-stage patients.
Yes.
You can get the general overall statistics is 70-80% response rates, but of course how durable that response is going to be is another issue.
Yes.
For the long term.
So you use this mostly on very difficult cases?
Generally, since these are experimental treatments, we get special permission from the Ministry of Health.
And also from the page.
Yes, of course. The most common application of CAR T cells is in hematological malignancies, leukemias, lymphomas that are caused by a cell type called B cells. So there is a molecule called CD19 on these B cells that we can target using CAR T cells. But we are also trying to open up new possibilities working on other types of cancers. For example, I do a lot of work on melanoma, skin cancers, and the use of natural killer cells to treat such patients. But these are still in the preclinical stage. We still have some time to come to clinical application. Yeah. But B-cell lymphomas, B-cell leukemias, multiple myeloma, these kind of tumors are routinely, I could say maybe, or more commonly treated with CAR T cells nowadays.
Dacă vrei să fii contactat de un consultant, scrie ACI Badem în comentarii.